Welcome to a session on construction and operation of a common base NPN and PNP transistor. A transistor is a semiconductor device. It consists of three regions: emitter, base, and collector. These three regions are separated by two PN junctions. So, first PN junction exists between emitter and base. This is also called as emitter-base junction. Second PN junction exists between base and collector. This is called as a base-collector junction. Here, transistors are of two types. One is NPN transistor and another one is PNP transistor. Emitter is heavily doped. Base is lightly doped and it is very, very thin. And collector is moderately doped. And it occupies largest area when compared to emitter and base. Let us see the representation of a transistor. This is the symbolic representation of a NPN transistor and this is the symbolic representation of a PNP transistor. If arrowhead is from base to emitter, then it is a NPN transistor. If arrowhead is from emitter to base, then it is a PNP transistor. Here, arrowhead represents the conventional flow of electric current. Let us see the different biasing conditions of transistors. If emitter base junction, collector base junction, both are forward biased, then transistor is said to be in saturation region. If emitter base junction and collector base junction, both are reverse biased, then transistor is said to be in cutoff region. If emitter base junction is under reverse bias mode and collector base junction is under forward bias condition, then the transistor is said to be in inverted mode. If emitter base junction is forward biased, collector base junction is reverse biased, transistor is said to be in active region or normal mode. Normally, we use the transistor in this mode only, active region or normal mode. Let us see the working of a common base NPN transistor. First of all, understand what is common base configuration. To work any electronic device, it should have four terminals, two for input, two for output. Here, transistor having only three terminals, emitter, base, and collector. So, to overcome this problem, base is made common for input as well as output. So, that's why this is called as a common base configuration of a NPN transistor. Let us see the working. Here, this emitter is made up of with N region and base is made up of with P region and collector is made up of with N region. Here emitter base junction is forward biased and base collector junction is reverse biased. N region is connected to negative terminal, P region is connected to positive terminal. Hence this emitter base junction is forward biased. P region is connected to negative terminal and N region is connected to positive terminal. Hence base collector junction is reverse biased. When we apply sufficient forward bias voltage, this negative terminal repels the electrons. Due to this, these electrons forced to enter into base region. As the electron moves in this emitter region, it constitutes a current. This current is called as emitter current IE. The electrons which are entered into the base may recombine with the holes, but the percentage of recombination is less than 5% because base is very, very thin and lightly doped. If holes in P region are recombined with electrons, fresh holes will be supplied to the base region from the battery positive terminal. As holes move in this direction, it constitutes a base current IB. The remaining 95% of the electrons will be transferred to the collector. Here the collector is connected to the battery positive terminal. So the electrons got attracted by this positive terminal of the battery. So the electrons moves in this direction. When the electrons moves inside the collector part, it constitutes a collector current IC. So we can write emitter current is equal to base current plus collector current. And the electrons will be resupplied to the emitter. In this way, NPN transistor works in common base configuration. Let us see the working of a PNP transistor, which is in common base configuration. Here it is emitter, base, and collector. Emitter is made up of with P region, base is made up of with N region, and collector is made up of with P region. Here P P region is connected to battery positive terminal, N region is connected to battery negative terminal. Hence, emitter base junction is forward biased. Here, base is N region, collector is P region. Here, N region is connected to battery positive terminal and P region is connected to battery negative terminal. Hence, base collector region is reverse biased. When sufficient amount of forward bias voltage is applied, this positive terminal repels the holes. Due to this, holes are forced to enter into the base part. When the holes are moving in emitter region, they constitute a current, which is called as emitter current. When holes enter into the base region, some of the holes may recombine with the electrons, but the recombination percentage is less than 5% because base is lightly doped and very, very thin. When some of the holes are recombined with the electrons, the fresh electrons in the N region or base part will be supplied by battery negative terminal. As the electron moves in this direction, a current will be produced due to the motion of electrons. It is nothing but a base current IB. Now, 95% of the holes will be transferred to the collector section. So this collector is connected to the battery negative terminal. So this hole is attracted by battery negative terminal. In this way, the hole moves. As the hole moves in the collector region, it constitutes a current, collector current. This is IC. So we can write IE is equal to IB plus IC. As hole reaches the edge of the P region, a electron from the negative terminal of the battery recombined with that hole. In this way, here in P region, electron hole pair will produces due to the breaking of covalent bond, and electrons recombined with the holes at the edge of the collector region. In this way, PNP transistor works. Thanks for watching.